Hello friends, in this video we will study Bresnahan's line algorithm. So there is one more algorithm to generate a line which is called as Bresnahan's line algorithm. It is based on incremental method.
So Bresnahan's line algorithm.
So this algorithm also have two cases for slope less than 1 and for slope greater than 1. So now first we will derive the algorithm for slope less than 1. So consider a line which will have some start point. I will name it as x1 y1. It will have some end point, that is x2 y2, and it will have some ith point, so I will name it as xi yi. So let x1 y1 be the start point on the line, x2 y2 will be the end point on the line, and xi yi be the ith point on a line, and xi plus 1 comma yi plus 1 be the I plus 1th point on the line. So these are the variables which are declared. Now for m less than 1, the xi plus 1th point will be xi plus 1 as shown in the figure, but for y plus 1th point it will have two value, that is yi or yi plus 1. So now we'll consider a point on a line. So we'll consider a point on the line whose x coordinate will be xi plus 1 and the y coordinate will be y, which is unknown. So it will be calculated as, so for x coordinate the value will be xi plus 1, and for y coordinate it will be y. So for calculating this value y, which is unknown, it is calculated as y equal to mx plus c, where the value of x is xi plus 1. So it will become as mxi plus m plus c. So in this way the y will be calculated. Now we'll consider the two figure. So we'll consider distance d1 and d2. So now this point is the starting point and this is the ending point. So I will name it as xi. Any point on the line, that is xi, the difference is 1, that is for I plus 1 this will be the I plus 1th point, that is xi plus 1, and this is yi and this will be yi plus 1th point. So I will name the coordinates. So this will become, this point will become, the coordinates will become xi plus 1 and yi, and this will become this point xi plus 1 comma yi plus 1. Similarly this figure,
So now, here the distance d1 and d2 will consider. Here distance d1 is less than d2, which means that d1 minus d2 is less than 0. So here the distance d2 is greater than this distance d1, which means that d1 is closer to this point. So we will take the coordinate of d1. So initially xi plus 1 is xi plus 1, and now yi plus 1 will become, so I will take the coordinates of d1, so it will become, so it is yi. Similarly for this figure, here d1 is greater than d2, distance d1 is greater than distance d2, so d1 minus d2 is greater than 0. So here the x coordinate will remain unchanged, so xi plus 1 will become xi plus 1, and yi plus 1, so I will take the coordinate of this, that is d2, the coordinate of d2 is yi plus 1, so it will become yi plus 1. So two conditions are there, that is distance d1 on the basis of distance d1 and d2, means if d1 is less than d2, the yi plus 1 value will be equal to yi, and for distance d1 greater than d2, the yi plus 1th point whose value will be yi plus 1. So now from the diagram, d1, so the value of this d1, which is equal to y minus yi. So here the coordinates are xi plus 1 into y, which is unknown. So the coordinate of this point, so I have to calculate this d1. So d1 is calculated, that is till here it is yi, and till here it is y. So this y minus this yi, I will get this distance d1. So that's why y minus yi. Similarly for d2, so this distance I have to calculate, so d2, so the whole is yi plus 1, and this distance, that is still here, it is y, so by yi plus 1, so will my yi plus 1 minus this y, I will get this this distance. So yi plus 1 minus y. So now I got the relation for d1 and d2. The next thing I will do is d1 minus d2. So d1 minus d2, which is equal to 2yi d1 minus d2, which is equal to 2y minus 2yi minus 1. But we know that the value of y, so the value of y is mxi plus m plus c. So I will replace this value of y in this equation, that is d1 minus d2 equation. So it will become, it is mxi plus m plus c. So the equation will become d1 minus d2. So 2 mxi plus m plus c minus 2 yi plus c. So I will get as d1 minus d2 as 2 mxi minus 2 yi plus 2 m plus 2 c minus 1. So now I will name this whole term as k. So I will put this whole term as k, so it will become d1 minus d2 equal to mxi minus 2yi plus k. And one more thing, that is m is equal to dy by dx. I will replace m by dy by dx in this equation, so it will become 2 dy by dx to xi minus 2yi plus k. So I will do cross multiplication. So afterwards it will become d1 minus d2 into dx, which is equal to 2 dy xi minus 2 yi into dx plus k dx. Now I will model this term as pi, where pi is decision parameter. So now pi, which is equal to 2 pi, which is equal to 2 dy xi minus 2 y dx plus k dx xi minus 2 y I dx plus k dx. So I will name it as equation 1. Similarly, for I plus 1th pixel, for I plus 1th pixel, it will become P I plus 1, which is equal to 2 dy xi plus 1 minus 2 y I plus 1 into dx plus k dx. So I will give it as equation 2. Now I will subtracting equation 2 by 1. So I will subtract equation 2 by equation 1. So I will get as pi plus 1, which is equal to pi plus 2 dy xi plus 1 minus xi minus 2 dx. So after subtracting equation 2 by 1, we get this equation. So I will name this equation as 3. So if pi less than 0, that is this condition, if pi is less than 0, xi plus 1 will be xi plus 1 and yi plus 1 will be yi. Similarly, that is d1 minus d2, we are modeling it as decision parameter, d1 minus d2 as decision parameter. If decision parameter is less than 0, then xi plus 1 will be xi plus 1 and yi plus 1 will be yi. And for decision parameter greater than 0, xi plus 1 will be xi plus 1 and yi plus 1 will be yi plus 1. So if pi equal to 0, if pi is less than 0, so then xi plus 1th pixel will be xi plus 1 and yi plus 1th pixel will be yi. So we will replace this equation of xi plus 1 and yi plus 1 in equation 3. So it will become, we'll put it in equation 3. So it will become pi plus 1 equal to pi plus 2 into dy. So I got pi plus 1 as pi plus 2 dy. So I will give it as equation 4. Similarly, for decision parameter greater than 0, so xi plus 1th pixel will be xi plus 1 and for yi plus 1th pixel will be yi plus 1. So now I will put this it in equation 3. So it will become pi plus 1 equal to pi plus 2 dy minus 2 dx. So I will give it as equation 5. So now condition for plotting of first pixel. So condition for plotting of first pixel. So for plotting first pixel, we'll put x, that is xi equal to x1 and yi equal to y1, and pi will be p1 in equation 1. So we have equation 1, that is so we will replace xi equal to x1, yi equal to y1 in this equation. So the corresponding equation will become p1 equal to 2 dy x1 minus 2 dx y1 plus k into dx. But we know the value of k as 2m plus 2c minus 1, so we'll replace p1 as 2 dy x1 minus 2 dx y1 plus the value of k, that is 2m into dx, 2c into dx minus dx. So now we also know that m equal to dy by dx. So I will get, after replacing the value of m as dy by dx, I will get p1 as 2 dy x1 minus 2 dx y1 plus 2 dy plus 2 c dx minus dx. So after replacing the value of m is equal to dy by dx, I get p1 as 2 dy x1 minus 2 dx y1 plus 2 dy plus 2 c dx minus dx. So now I have to eliminate this c term. So for that I have to do some adjustment. So I'm doing some adjustment, just like y is equal to mx plus c for y equal to 1, that is for y1 it will be x1. So we know that m is equal to dy by dx, so I'm getting as y is equal to dy by dx x1 plus c. So after cross multiplication it will become 2 dx y1, it will become dx into y1 equal to dy x1 plus c. Now I'm multiplying this equation by 2, so it will become 2 dx y1 equal to 2 dy x1 plus 2c into dx. So you can see this two term, 2 dy x1 and 2c dx is common here, which means that in place of this two term I will directly write 2 dx y1. So now it will become p1 equal to 2 dy dx y1 minus 2 dx y1 plus 2 dy minus dx. So this term get cancelled and p1 will equal to 2 dy minus dx. So we'll use this equation and I will model it as equation 6. So I've successfully wrote down the explanation for Brestnev lines algorithm for m less than 1. Thank you.